in San Jose, Robert Honda for the 10 o'clock news.
Mark Ibanez joins us now. He's got some good news about the Warriors.
Yeah, under the category of it's about time, the Warriors did find someone they could beat, the lowly Clippers, but there were some good highlights to go along with it. And a big day for colleges and high schools, National Letter of Intent Day. Joe Fonte will be along with a full report on the East Bay High School that is definitely beating the system for higher education. Got it all next with sports.
Freedom!
When you open your mind, incredible things start to happen. Function becomes form, form becomes beauty. Introducing the all-new Elantra from Hyundai, with a long list of features including front and side airbags and the freedom of America's best warranty plan. The new Elantra, the way it looks will open your mind, the way it's backed will
free your mind, and the rest will follow.
Boneheads, earn a $1,000 bonus every workday. Listen to earn $1,000 a day. Classic rock that pays. 107.7 The Bone.
Need a little excitement these days? Just check your Albertsons weekly ad. Look for the select coupons for Coca-Cola or Nestle products and enter to win a family vacation for four to experience Disney's newest theme park, Disney's California Adventure, right next door to Disneyland Park in California. Hey, it's your life. Albertsons, it's your store.
Criminals can run, even change their appearance, but they can't hide from the Bay Area's newest high-tech crime-fighting tool. Thursday at 10 on KTVU Fox 2.
Now and get 2-for-1 or 50% off for yourself. 24-hour fitness, one great investment.
Number one news team for tonight's top stories. The 11 o'clock edition of the original 10 o'clock news is coming up on KICU 36 Cable 6. Genuine interest. Member FDIC.
Announcing the first offer we've ever made. So it's a really good one. Sign up with Singular Wireless and get unlimited calling to other Singular customers in your home area. So you're connected to all your buds with no airtime charges. Plus, you'll get a sleek Nokia 8200 series phone for just $99. Announcing Singular Wireless. What do you have to say?
They are two of the most unwatchable teams in all of basketball, but they have two of the most entertaining young stars in the league right now. So, since the NBA has turned into a league of individuals, it makes sense to hone in on them. And, oh, by the way, there was a final score between the Warriors and Clippers. Here's the guy from L.A. worth checking out. Lamar Odom, 6'10". Look at him move into the lane for his little left-hand hook. And for the Warriors, night after night, Antoine Jamison is worth checking out. Matching Odom, bucket for bucket, power move in the lane. Clippers and Warriors were even up for the most part all night. And here's more from Odom. Lamar using his body nicely to protect the ball. Jamison fouled him, and down goes the shot, 27 for Odom to lead the Clippers. But now it's Antoine against Odom this time. Finds a way to get this thing to fall. 27 for Jamison. and the teams remain very tight. Warriors have the worst defense in the league. Here's an example, 5 seconds left. Look how open the Clippers' best three-point shooter gets. Eric Piakowski bombed away to tie it with 3.2 left, but the Warriors have time to win it. Foolish foul on Bobby Sur. Watch him. He has no real shot on the baseline, and they commit the foul, and Sur hit one of two free throws, and the Warriors go away winners over the Clippers by one. And kind of a nice way to head into the All-Star break. Warriors can kick back until Tuesday before they play for real again. You know, when you think of high school dominance in the Bay Area anyway, of course, De La Salle comes to mind. But on this National Letter of Intent Day, another football power demanding attention. No school sends more athletes off on full-ride scholarships than Skyline High in Oakland. Joe Fonzi highlights their story.
It's become an annual event on Letter of Intent Day, the celebration at Skyline High in Oakland honoring the current year's group of football players accepting Division I scholarships. This year there were five, more than any other high school in the area. The list is headed by Kirk Johnson, a linebacker for the Titans who will attend Arizona. Johnson scored three defensive touchdowns this season in a single game.
Ever since I can remember, I've been wanting to play football and get a scholarship. My dad played football, and ever since I can remember, I had a football in my hand, so it relieves a lot of stress and brings a lot of joy to my heart.
At Arizona, Johnson will get a chance to play against his high school teammate, Harrison Smith. Smith, a wide receiver and defensive back for the Titans, is headed to Cal. Two other players may suit up against each other one day as well. Terry Johnson is going to Fresno State, and wide receiver Rufus Skillern will attend San Jose State.
I look forward to seeing him on the field and seeing him after the game, so when we beat Fresno State or whatever, so I look forward to it.
It'll all be new for cornerback Jairus Wilkinson, who's headed across the country to Georgia Tech. But just like the players enjoy here at Skyline, Wilkinson will have a support system even though he's 3,000 miles from the Bay Area.
My dad lives out there, you know, so that'll be a little family out there already. And I was born in Atlanta, and I always wanted to go back and live out there. So I decided, you know, it'd be nice to go out there for college.
The guy who has consistently helped Skyline players achieve their athletic and academic goals is head coach and athletic director John Beam. In an era when dedicated on-campus coaches are hard to find, Beam's teams continue to win, and his players continue to advance into college.
As society changes around them, it's not cool to put in a lot of time. It's not cool to work hard. Everything's now, now, now. But we do have a reputation. We do have a tradition. And so it does help perpetuate and move it forward.
Without Coach Beam, I don't know if I'd have been signed today.
An 11-1 season, a Silver Bowl championship, and five players headed to Division I schools. Just another year we've come to expect from John Beam and Skyline. In Oakland, Joe Fonzi for the 10 o'clock news.
That's a great story. Meanwhile, here's something that's starting to happen on a more regular basis, it seems anyway. Players